Mark, what's a little bit more of like the implementation process for when Devin comes back? Like, is he just going to kind of jump back into where he was with you guys previously, or is he going to be starting, you know, over, or what just what's that process going to be like? You guys don't usually have guys miss all of fall camp.
Yeah, I mean, inevitably, I would imagine it'd be a little rust, gold dusted rust, but we'll see. I mean, he's a guy that I think that, you know, when you talk about the greed of the hand and that whole concept, he's been great at everything, and he wants to come back and be a great football player. And when that whole scenario plays out, we'll make it work. And he's just such a kind of a competitive perfectionist and all the things that he's done. I don't anticipate that being an issue. And obviously, our team and our whole program is 100% behind him. I think it did, yeah. We actually, I know it did, because, you know, having that conversation with him, it's kind of good and bad, you know, it would be nice to just look over to him and strange kind of guy, you know, is that what we call it, is that our adjustment, but I think he kind of is a sponge, he runs things very well, and his biggest thing is how he redirects that to each individual, and gets to know how they learn, how they respond. How to think that's such a big deal, quarterback, because you have to be totally confident that everything you're doing, you have to be able to fail in the play the next play with that, you know, total blind confidence again, and so his, he did a great job at the two of kind of questioning, you know, a lot of things that we do and why we do it, how we do it, which I think, you know, validated a bunch of things that we do and why we do it, and also, you know,
tweak a few things and polish a few things that we changed. Did you have a different kind of perspective after working with wideouts? He said that that sort of changed her as a coach. Did you see, like, oh, that's not a quarterback coach, right? Like, I think that he's quarterback guy. You know, I think that's always what he wanted to be. He wanted to be, and I think that probably helped.
I think it helps the coach wideouts from a quarterback's perspective a lot more than it helps the coach quarterback from a wideout perspective. And so that probably helped a little bit more that way. In any time you're expanding your expertise and expanding your knowledge, so
how willing would you, be to let the quarterback competition go into the regular season? Is that something you've anticipated at all?
It's got to happen. You know, it can't be something where you're 52.7% of the work for somebody else's. You know, you don't want those little tiny nuances. You want it to be obvious and glaring, and everybody kind of looks at each other and goes, yeah, you know, last year was a unanimous vote. It was no question about that. And it can't be fake, it can't be artificial, staged, any of those type of descriptors. It's got to happen. Right now is the time when a lot of that happens for those guys. Guys that go to work and relearn their terminology, and some guys that run it for the first time, and then hit the ground and fall down. And our deal is we have to put them in their best, you know, in their best kind of avenue of our offense, within our offense, to succeed.
Is it guy?
We find we had three guys in spring that were all very similar and completely different. Guys that in Korea had played a lot of college football, different plays, all those things, completely inexperienced in our system, and you could see those wheels turning. Of, you know, okay, we called that red, and we called that, you know, water, or whatever it is. And those you're stuck a few times. Sometimes they're all trying to you know, win the job or the next snow, and that's the worst kind of, you know, kind of perspective you can take into it. Travis Johnson was there. He was there for a year, but didn't practice. He was just not able to practice. And so he was there, and he knows the terminology. He hadn't actually done it. And so there was that learning curve. And Jerry Wilson, you know, popped off the plane and started practicing. Again, this summer will be big for all those guys, just from a confidence standpoint, and they will all be completely different guys in fact, completely.
Was Johnson terminated by injuries? Is that what you mean? I'm sorry, was Johnson terminated by injuries?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, there are uniform changes. Yes, there's some that are expansive, some that are not. They're all cool, all very cool. So we won't look as good as Kip Burrow looks right now, but we'll try. I mean, let's be honest, right? Well, from a fan's perspective, hopefully they're coming with total confidence, passion, speed, commitment to our scheme. And, you know, just for whatever reason, that never totally 100% clicked last year. We have to get some very formal tests and that's a great, how we stood up and had a few games and overcame some things. But I thought that was the biggest thing coming in, is how quickly that took place.
How do you feel about your offensive line right now? There's been a lot of talk about that group being really special potentially this year.
I think our offensive line is a bit like our season four was 2 years ago when nobody knew who anybody was, but we were excited to know it's kind of that you expect this guy to become Devin Allen or Grant Carrington or Grant Stanford. And it's kind of the same way. Two guys are pretty established, they've played a lot. And then we have a bunch of guys that haven't played at all. And we have a few guys in between. I think Steve Dickwood always done a good job of having those guys trained to play their positions. And boy, that's going to be tested. Unfortunately, the position they play in the football, we're going to need a 10 or 8 9 of them to show up and play great. And we expect them to.
Some of the
dog game last year help your program in any sense responding to that?
I've been asked 97 times about the Utah game. I'm trying to forget it now because that's another question. No, it was one of those things, when 2021 I think and Travis coming back home run, it was a one man right there. From there they played perfectly and it still got us. And I think the key to our season going forward last year was everybody sat in the same room and we sat there and watched the same film of the same play. I can't remember maybe 7 or 8 plays before that, the exact same offensive play, the exact same defensive call, which was a 2 yard loss. And just that can't just one mistake is one mistake. It's kind of like playing quarterback and you're thinking about the three interceptions that you asked me going to the next game that doesn't help it. Why you did it, and not to be doing that actually tell you have to lean forward and go. And we didn't for whatever reason in that starts with me, but I think our guys, our staff did a great job of ending that and doing what we're doing to the other part of the season.
Some of the FCS coaches I talked to said they weren't worried about whether Dakota was good enough to play at the Pac-12 level. They were just concerned about how physical he played at the FCS level, whether that would translate, when you got bigger and faster players. Are you guys going to try to rein that in at all with him, or is it kind of...
That's one of those things you can't really do. It's kind of like somebody asked me, how many carries do you want to give Royce
three? Right.
As many as we possibly can without him ever losing a step. It's kind of like running quarterback is... What's the magic number until he gets hurt?
Right.
And then he yells at you. And that's always you're playing that part of it, you're playing his natural instinct. In our spring ball, our quarterback is not live, so that almost inhibits the offense a little bit. And certainly inhibits their natural tendency to maybe take off running or to make something like that isn't there. They might break a tackle and probably blow the whistle and give the defensive end from the back. So that's always it's more of a psychological thing for the quarterback than
because he's a lot more of a pure runner than what you guys have had in the past. I mean, obviously Marcus could take off with it, but he was you know, more of a traditional quarterback who could happen to run, same with Vernon too. Is that kind of how you guys assess Dakota as well?
Yeah, somewhere in between. He's obviously the biggest thing for him is having played a lot of
right.
the system, so seeing that advance. But again, I anticipate not being able to recognize all three of those guys in the first drive. I think they'd be three completely different, better, dynamic guys than in spring ball. Because there's not that hesitation of, you know, uncertainty or translation of whatever it is, and they're just going. And so, I'm pretty much looking forward to that.
What you mentioned before is Buckner.